Did you? Even the
oh, that's very nice.
Very photogenic.
Oh boy.
Do you want the end?
Yeah.
Which first one or last one?
Yeah. This one. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Hey, no, seriously. What do you guys think? I know you agree with me. Come on.
Okay. Carry on.
You can sit with me right there if you're in charge. I know he would do it too.
Yeah. I know.
Hey, we're doing this end, right?
Huh?
Should we come this way, right? Am I over here?
25. What's the move?
I better go get Ray.
Kind of watch you rocking up there.
I just want 925 and
09. Probably, yeah.
Are you seeing that?
Morning to you.
Good morning. Ah, top of the morning.
Top of the morning to you.
Yeah, we go to Northeastern
State.
What? Oh, we do this all the time.
Flowers. It's hard to make it. Well, it's like a mix. It's like a mix.
I like the biggest board meets are where board meets are in state, Oklahoma. Northeastern, you know, you have to have good grades to get in.
Oh, yeah.
It's got that, like a 4.0, like weighted.
I got to run against a lily pad. It's the right name.
Thanks, Nana. You're my only follower today. I need 7 more followers to get to $20. Come on, folks. Dial in. Operators are standing by.
I do. Sounds like a Sharpie or a standard.
I
Good.
Morning.
Sitting in the building.
Let's read the prayer of confession. When we read the prayer of confession, let's not just read words. Let us bring those words into our lives. Let us pray. Father,
sins have separated me from you. I am truly sorry, and now I want to turn away from my past sinful life toward you. Please forgive me and help me avoid sinning again. I believe that your Son, Jesus Christ, died for my sins, was resurrected from the dead, is alive, and hears my prayer. I invite Jesus to become the Lord of my life, to rule and reign in my heart from this day forward. Please send your Holy Spirit to help me obey you and do your will for the rest of my life. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Please be seated. Well, let us take a moment and come to our Lord, open our hearts, and have Him forgive us of all the sins we have committed. He knows the sins, but He wants us to come to Him. Let us pray. Father, we ask you to forgive the sins we have committed. When we open our hearts to you, and let you live within us, but let us follow your word. And Father, help us from sinning again. This day and every day, when we are truly sorry for the sins we have committed, in Jesus' name, they are. please open your Bibles to the Gospel of John, chapter 20, verses 19 through 23. And what we see in John right now, Jesus has been crucified, has been buried, has been raised from the dead. Mary Magdalene and the other Mary have found him, and he appeared to them. Yet the disciples were not sure, and they locked themselves away because they were afraid of what the Jews might do to followers of Jesus Christ. Let us begin. From John 20, verse 19. When it was evening on that day, the first day of the week, and the doors of the house where the disciples had met were locked for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood among them and said to them, "Peace be with you." As he said this, he showed them his hands and his side. And the disciples rejoiced when they saw that it was the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." When he said this, he breathed on them and said, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you retain the sins of any, they will be retained." So is the reading of God's gracious and holy word. As I had said earlier, Jesus had been crucified, was laid in the tomb. And the Marys came and found the tomb with the stone rolled back. Jesus wasn't there. They went away and they were sad, but Jesus appeared to them. And they were excited and they rushed to tell the disciples. But later on, the disciples were afraid of the Jews, because the Jews might come and do bad things to them. So they locked themselves away. They were afraid that the Jews had taken Jesus away and took him somewhere else. But Jesus appeared to them. Remember, he said he would die, and on the third day he arose, and he did. But then he gave us this message. He gave this message to you, and he gave this message to me. And we should follow this every single day. It says, and he said to the disciples, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so Jesus said, so I send you." Jesus is giving us, those who follow him, those who do his will, a direction. He's telling us, not "would you please." He says, if you follow me, if you follow the Father, then I'm sending you. I send you. Peace be with you. Peace be inside us, so that we're comforted, that we know when we follow Jesus, that our lives will change for the better. It doesn't mean we're going to go through everything as great, everything's going to be roses. Jesus didn't go through all that either. But he says, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me," said Jesus. Jesus said to you and to me, those who believe, and if you believe, he's sending us. Jesus says to us, "I will send you." So we have to do his work and his will. Not just once in a while, just not once on Sunday, not just every time, but he sends us out on a constant basis to do his work and will. That's what we have to show. Each and every one of us that are here today, has an opportunity to show that Jesus lives in you. But you have to go out. He said, not just sit at home or when it's convenient. He said, peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, I'm sending you. You go out there. You start telling people how great Jesus is, how his forgiveness of sins are there, how their lives can be better. It's now up to all of you to go out there and share Christ. Now today we're having our graduates, and they're starting really their lives now. They graduated from high school, and boy, they've got the world all tied up. And we know, all of us who follow Christ, when we graduated from high school, everything after that was easy. No, guys, your lives are just beginning. We think we've been through. Now your parents say, okay, it's time to continue. To continue in your lives, to build that lives, to build what you have. But don't forget Jesus Christ. When you're building your lives, when you're starting your lives, take him with you no matter where you go. As he sent the disciples, he's sending those who believe in him out so that they can spread the word of God. So not just that generation, but every single generation can spread the word of God. All of us. That's what we're assigned to, is to go out, to start sending and spreading the word of God. Jesus forgives sins, and he forgives us. And so we should forgive others. But we have to go out. It's not once in a while. It's putting Christ in our hearts every single day and going out. Because Jesus says, peace be with you. I'm sending you forth. I'm sending you out to spread the word of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. So don't let Christ just sit here at church. Bring him with you in your daily lives. Every one of us. Especially our new seniors. Oh, excuse me. Graduates. The nice thing about being a graduate, starting Monday morning, your parents will be sending you out and finding jobs. They will give you at least 2 weeks to find your own place. 3 weeks later, your parents will be having their own car. Find you a letter. But it's just the beginning, all of our lives. But the interesting part of it, we can see that in our seniors, but we should see it in our own lives. Every day is a new beginning. Every day is a new challenge. But when we have Christ in our lives, we have peace in our lives. And we go out and we spread the word of Jesus Christ.
Operation Song is an organization in Nashville that meets with veterans, and they take their experiences and they help put them in a song, and they publish about 700 of those songs now. This is one of them. It was written by 6 veterans from the Afghanistan, Iraq, and Vietnam wars. And then it was sang and recorded by an artist named Ward Davis and two other veterans who sang along on it, and it's called The Last Monday Night. I took a bus to Paul in Chancellorsville. Went down and I lie there still. Underneath, across the stone. Real past early time we've gone. There are seasons when it seems. Everyone's forgotten me till the last Monday of May. All springtime flowers bloom, come and decorate my grave, but only bones lie here. Spirit flies as high as old glory waves on the last Monday May. Far on a distant shore, spirit flies as high as old. life that is just the beginning. It's a challenge. It's a wonderful challenge with Christ in our lives. I'll ask our seniors that are here, please come forward. That we've been blessed with is knowing these guys and girls. Hey, put you in the middle. And we want to bless them and send them on their way with prayer, a blessing, and thanksgiving. Father, I ask you to bless these seniors that have graduated. Because, Father, they are going on with life. And Father, only you know what they are going to go through, but yet their lives can be changed when they are blessed with having you in their lives. So, Father, I ask to bless each one here today, putting a blessing upon each one of them so that they might travel through the rest of their lives helping others and teaching them about Christ. Father, as the blessings come upon them, let us be thankful for all we have and do. But I ask you to bless them and keep them safe. But have them have the strength of putting Christ in their lives each and every day. In your gracious and holy name, we pray. Amen. Tom, can you help us? We have a few gifts here today, there's the books that are in there. We have four books for children and one book for a wonderful lady. Would you stand, come up, A.J. Lure? Greg Rossi. Jordan. Hartley. Keegan. Shane. Now, hi, Tessa. Please come forward. I'm not just pointing her out because she has been an outstanding help to everyone. But if you stand in the middle again, you will see that God has blessed her by being a lot prettier than they are. Each one of these. And I'm going to be here long enough now to marry some of their family and to see them after they were born and see what great things God has blessed them with. We ask you to bow your heads and let us pray together. Father, send your blessings upon them as they go forth into a life that is only satisfied through you. Bless them and guide them. And make them have the right decisions and call upon you when the time is right. So the decisions they make are your decisions and not theirs. But lead them. Fill their hearts with love and caring that only Jesus Christ can give them. This day and every day, we pray and we all say, amen.
She hasn't been the only girl, but almost. So thank you guys. You've been a blessing to me and to this church. Continue to do so. Amen. Go.
Thank you.
Father, let us go out and let us search others and let us bring Christ to all who could hear. Amen. Please be seated. One of the things I would like to do is to recognize anyone during this Memorial Day weekend, those who have been in the military or given themselves within God's service. Now, first I'll say, well, those who have served in the military, please stand. Nobody has served in the military. Okay. And Richard has. Why aren't you standing, Richard? He says, oh, he is standing. I'm sorry. I had to give him a hard time. Thank you for it. And we are so thankful and blessed by them. I'd also like to recognize anyone who has given themselves to the community, either as AI patrol or police forces. Please stand. Thank you. Anyone that has been firemen or volunteered their time and effort to do so? Yes? And we thank them. Let us thank them with a blessing. Father, we thank those who are serving and being there for others during this time. We ask you to bless them and bless all who have put their lives on the line for each and every one of us. So, Father, it is just not a job, it is a calling to serve you and to serve your country. And Father, in your gracious name, we pray. Amen. Well, let us please, well, before we do that, there was a couple names that seniors could not be here. Wesley Backus and Nikita Schenkel could not be here with us. They were seniors, and we want to make sure we keep them also in our prayers. Well, let us please stand, and let us sing the final hymn, My Country Tis of Thee, found on 807.
My country, tis of Thee, found on 807.
And during the parades and all that are there, let us be thankful that we are in a free, blessed country that so many countries in the world do not have. And I've been in some of those countries, and we are so, so well blessed. As you see the flag here today, along with the Christian flag, it is God who has blessed us. But let us bless and thank God, but let us keep this country, the country that we have, through Jesus Christ and the Father in heaven. Now may our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, may the Father in heaven be with each and every one of you, now and forevermore. And we say,
Amen.
Start your little banner.
Oh, yeah, look. Oh, it starts being weird. Oh, yeah. I never knew they put.
Maybe Grandma can take a picture of us.